Those who are in favor of the motion to approve the report of the technical working group, please raise your right hand.
The media is saying they have a right to know. I would only like to state that perhaps, since the media should serve the public interest, that their interpretation of right to know is not for the media's right to know, but for the public's right to know, both sides of the issues.
This is Jose Reno from Mendoza reporting for the Guidon. Today, we will be attending a hearing on the Freedom of Information Bill in the Mitra building of the Batasang Pambansang Complex. And later, the Guidon shall have an exclusive interview with Congressman Lorenzo Tañada III, one of the chief authors of the FOI Bill.
Good day, Representative Tañada. So how does it feel after finally getting the FOI Bill out of Congress?
Well, of course, it's a relief, but like I said, this is just the first step. The battle is in the plenary. And this is why I kept mentioning to the members of the committee that if there are things that you feel should be raised again, you can raise it in the committee following our parliamentary procedure. So this is not the end of the day. This is just the start of lawmaking. And we're happy that we were able to get it out of the committee, and we're ready to face the challenge in getting it over the hurdle of the plenary.
So what do you think in the plenary would you still have to go through?
Well, of course, it will be sponsored, then there will be an interpellation and debate, and then after that, period of amendments. So these are the steps that we would be going through in order that the bill may be voted on third reading.
Has the president been supportive?
Well, the president in January of 2012 came out with a statement that he is in favor of the freedom of information. Now, some people say that why not certify or come out strongly. Well, I still believe that we are three independent branches of government. You have the legislative, judiciary, and for me, the president need not come out, because if that's the case, then we might as well dissolve the legislative branch. No, so it is supposed to be the congressmen or the senators who should come up front, no, and ensure that this piece of legislation be enacted into law.
And a lot of this controversy a while ago in the hearing has been press responsibility, media responsibility. What can you say about this?
Well, I think it's a wake-up call. I think no one will deny that there is an issue with corruption in certain media practitioners. So it is a challenge to the whole entity, that how do they police the ranks? How do they reprimand, punish people who are caught doing illegal activities? So this is the reason why you get this so much reaction, no, and emotion from some congressmen. Whether rightly or wrongly, so it should always be in the minds of media that when they do a story or when they cover an issue, that they try their best to get both sides now, and make sure not only get both sides, but make sure that their side is also printed or broadcasted or mentioned in a story.
Why are they so afraid of the right to reply? Lech Walesa of Poland said, "What about responsibility? I think freedom of the press is a responsibility to be exercised by media in behalf of the public. The press freedom is not a monopoly of the press. It is a right of every citizen. Every citizen has the right for complete information, not only published information, without the right to reply. Anong klaseng impormasyon yun? Nabasa lang pagkatapos eh, meron naman palang mali. I think we have all our responsibility to our constituents for a complete information, and the right of reply is part of the freedom of information.
And the freedom of information also helps in this.
Well, the freedom of information is a citizen's right. It is not a media right. Let's make that clear. So it is much broader, and that's why I feel that the right of reply should not hold hostage the FOI bill just because there are certain concerns with regard to malpractices in the media sector.
In your opinion, what amendments should FOI go through in the plenary? Or
leave it to the people who would propose the amendments. But I'm sure that, and I assured the Department of National Defense that I would look into their concerns with regard to the repeal of MC number 78 and provide an amendment that it does not automatically, and the passage of the FOI does not automatically repeal it immediately, because there we have to agree that there are certain secrets that the military has to keep, if not the enemies of our country, whether external, will be able to find out these secrets. So we understand that. I take note of that, and I assured them that when we get to the period of amendments at the proper time, we will be willing to accept amendments with regard to that section.